Hey, what's going on, y'all? It is your boy, Velly. Two Wise back with another video, and today we have my Burden reaction. But before we dive into that, you already know we have to dive into the Instagram shoutouts. Now, if you want to be an Instagram shoutouts like these beautiful people right here, go ahead and follow me on Instagram at I'm Velly Two Wise, just like my mother effing YouTube, and you will be featured on videos just like these beautiful people in my intros. Thank you guys so much for supporting me. Oh my god. Thank you guys so much for supporting me on all my posts and polls and stuff on the stories and watching my stories and inboxing me and supporting me and sending me screenshots of you guys watching the videos. I love that type of shit. Thank you guys so much for that. But let's dive into the video.
I said, how do I lower this speaker again?
Make you lost a leak, got you running like a track star, shooting at his feet. Fuck COVID, but my mask on, feel like Leatherface, busting through the wall of radios. Hop up in a spaceship and we going wherever it go. Running with my fist up if you trying to catch a fade. I don't need a strap, I just need a blade, and I need a blunt, cause I've been high for days.
Okay, so our first song is literally called Burden. I'm so excited to dive into this album. You already know how we are when Spotify albums drop. We play them full through so we can hear the outro. Excuse me if you guys just heard that burp. Jesus Christ. We go full through so we can hear the outros and intros of every song and so we can hear how they connect to each other. So let's dive into this and hear this album together. Let's go. Oh my God. That was so fucking short and sweet, but damn, dude, that shit hits you, man. It really gives you a little hint of what's to come. That's what I feel like, because you don't just give us something that short and sweet and then give us an entirely new album or an entirely different album from that sound, at least. I love how that sounded. I really hope that was Bones singing and not a sample, because that sounded amazing. It sounded like he did something to his voice, made it a little deeper. This shit sounds fucking beautiful, bro. The fucking guitar, the amplified effect over the voice and the instrument. Holy shit, man. I'm gonna fucking love this thing. This is, by the way, my first Bones project hearing. This is going to be insane. This is going to be insane, guys. Holy shit. I forgot. I have on shuffle. Woo! A Xavier Wolf feature. Oh my god. You know these guys don't miss. Oh my god, we have to fucking chill. We have to chill. I'm not trying to get a headache. I have a slight fucking headache. Guys, oh my god, Bones is coming in saying, Bones, switch it up. Okay, I did it. Bones, do this. I did it, nigga. I did it. I did it. Holy shit, bro. Bones' fucking flow on this is insane. Insane, dude. It seems like he's getting bored of the same old shit, and he's just like, fuck it, man. I'm trying new shit and showing motherfuckers I can do that too. Holy shit, bro. Guys, I'm not fucking ready. I'm not ready. I told y'all I'm not ready for Singing Bones. And he's rapping and then just coming out of nowhere and just fucking singing on bridges and shit. Oh, shit. We're in for some shit. Okay. Okay.
Fuck whatever you got to say. I'm sipping and dipping, enjoying my day. Suckers hate because they ain't in my lane. You broken, you hate it. Go fall into place. Oh, bitch, get the fuck on my face. I'm getting it, spinning up all in a day. Penthouse while I'm making the play. Spit the clean 100,000 on James. I'm paid. Rude dog, nigga, all in the way. 350 blowing out of the way.
Bro, we. No. Xavier Wolf. Okay. Xavier Wolf coming in with the highest energy so far that we've heard in the project so far. I know we're only two verses in, but Jesus Christ, he came in heavy, and you need that in the beginning of an album. I don't care what nobody says, you need that high energy in the first or second fucking song. And Xavier and Bones are bringing that high energy this song with this fucking beat, the fucking vocals on it. I wonder if Xavier is going to come in with some melodic shit to it too at the end. So let's continue this right fucking now. Running straight to the cake, merch sales going up by the day. Suckers mad, I'm gonna show them the way. Hit it by yourself like I did, bitch. I won't ever try to help, I hope you flunk, bitch. This weed I'll be smoking smell like skunk shit. Hollow sets should get you killed in that mosh pit. Yeah, yeah, you gon' get killed in the mosh pit, bitch. It's belly spinning on the top of bitch. I don't know what I be saying. Yeah, belly in this bitch, going super hard off the dome. He off the shit, going super hard off the dome. He off the shit. He don't know where he going, but he gon' take your bitch. He don't know where he going, but he gon' take your bitch. Bro, this beat is insane. This beat is fucking insane. And I just fucking surprised the fuck out of myself with that verse. I thought I was gonna fuck up again. Oh, shit, bro. I'm becoming a god at freestyling. I'm becoming a god at freestyling, guys. I'm becoming a literal god at fucking freestyling, guys. You guys cannot say anything less. You can't say anything less. At first, it was just a little. Now, I can literally fucking freestyle an entire song. Yes, you guys are responsible for that. Thank you guys for that, because I've been wondering my whole life why I've not been able to freestyle. Now, I can just do it off the top of my head. The top of my fucking head. It's insane. This song is safe and sound. Oh my God. Dude, this is my type of music right here, dude. This, oh my God, dude. This project so far has given me chills. Every fucking song has given me chills. Every song so far. It's only been three, but every... Do you know what it means to get chills when you're listening to something? Like, you really like that shit. Like, your body's telling you, like, all right, we fucking with this. I don't give a fuck what you say. We fucking with this. Dude, I'm floating, guys. I can't right now, bruh. This shit is fucking amazing. I did not know. You guys need to understand. I did not know Bones had this in his repertoire. Fuck you talking about, however the fuck you say it. I don't even know how to spell that fucking word. Repertoire. What the fuck is that word? What is that? What is repertoire? But alright, nigga, this shit is fucking beautiful. So far, he's coming with three completely different sounds. I was fucking stupid to say that the entire project was going to sound like that first song. Because this is just fucking amazing so far. And we're not even in the fifth song. Let's just fucking go. And the guitars, dude. It's like two layers of guitar. Oh my. Dude, this shit's finna make me emotional. What the fuck? Waiting. I've been waiting for you. Dude, that's fucking beautiful, man. Jesus, this is. Waiting, I've been waiting for you at the door, and I don't know if I'ma see you ever again. I don't fucking know, guys. One headphone, the other head. Oh, dude. No sus. My nipples is hard as shit. My nipples hard as shit, my nigga. No sus. I have chills down my... Bro, four songs in, I have chills down my fucking spot. This month... No fucking sus. His delivery on this song is fucking amazing. How he's not overlapping the beat. Over fucking lapping the beat with the extra fucking auto-tune and fucking stupid shit. Let the beat talk too. Thank you, Bones. That's one thing I love that Pete does. Is that he lets the beat talk. He puts his vocals just as high as the beat. So the beat can speak just as much as he does. As far as his old music goes, I'm not very much sure with the newer production and all that, but Peep's production, when he put his hands on it, he let that fucking beat talk just as much. I love this shit. Live alone, die alone, in a second I'll be gone, ayy. Hey. Oh my god, dude. This shit's deep as fuck, man. It's beautiful nonetheless. But man, it's deep. This shit is going to get me fucking emotional. Oh my god, this fucking deeper fucking delivery is absolutely insane. It's insane. It is killing me. Hold on, guys. I think my dealer's here. I think the weed's here, guys. Dude, how he came in with the deeper fucking flow is absolutely insane, dude. I love when people switch up their melodic abilities, and in the beginning for the entire song, you think that he's gonna go high, like, and now he's coming in. I love that shit. I don't know the notes and shit. I don't know C. You guys probably like C major. It's C major. Like, come on, man. God. This motherfucker's talking and singing his ass off this time. And he has multiple verses for our ass. This is fucking amazing. I love the confidence behind this fucking melodic flow. When did he start doing this? Because everything I've heard has almost been a completely different sound. Like, this guy is so versatile. But then again, he's been in this shit for 10 years almost. I love me some fucking Bones. This motherfucker is crazy, bro. He's crazy. Switchblade on my left pocket. I don't know why I stop it. I don't know why I flodge it. Yeah, Veli and this bitch going harder than a bitch. Yeah, Veli and this bitch going harder than a bitch. That was kind of hard, bruh. Okay, before we dive into this, because it sounds like it's going to be melodic as well. But with Bones, you have no idea. You cannot expect a certain sound. That's one thing I've grown to know from listening to Bones. But the next song is Second Star to the Right. One thing I've noticed about all the songs is they are all mushed together. The titles are all mushed together. And that's sometimes how I type on Twitter. So it's kind of cool to see that. That's kind of fucking fire, you know? But yes, these are a bunch of long titles with a bunch of capital letters. But let's dive into this next song. That last song got your boy feeling right, bruh. I feel like going crazy on Miss Veli. Fuck you, I can't even lie. I can't lie, bro. I can't lie. This one's a minute and 29. These are a bunch of short songs, by the way. You can almost call this an album full of interludes. Oh my. The last thing I need for him to do with that beautiful melodic flow is to start screaming like Ruby in this bitch. That's the last thing I need him to do, because I'm going to lose my fucking mind. Okay, Bones, please think about me here. Think about me here, please. Come on. I be going hard, yeah, I be going hard, yeah, spinning off the dome, yeah, I be going hard, yeah, yeah. Featuring Veli, going off the top, man, my dope be smelly, going off the top, man, my hoes be going, 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 my hoes be going. Bro, this freestyling shit is honestly getting crazy, guys. It's getting crazy. It's getting fucking crazy. I have to see if my weed dealer's here. He's probably here. Okay, he's here, guys. This freestyling is getting crazy, guys. Hold on, let me go get my goddamn. Well, I'm back, guys. Holy shit. I had to up, guys. The editing is a bitch, bruh. Shit. The next song is Aluminum. I'm super excited to hear this. We're halfway through this thing. This shit is fucking fire so far. It's a different sound, it seems, every time. Even though he's been melodic on majority of the songs, he somehow made every song sound a little different. So, let's dive into this. I want to hear a little more rapping, I can't lie. But at the same time, this melodic Bones, man, is something so new to me and something so fresh that I want to dive into this more and more. So I'm getting the best of both fucking worlds here, guys. I'm getting the best of fucking both worlds in here, bruh. Holy shit. Ooh, it sounds like we're going to get some rapping on this one. This one, 2 minutes and 6 seconds. Ooh. Dude, Bones is on this motherfucker like Justin Timberlake. Dude, he sounds like Justin fucking Timberlake on this song. Dude, this is crazy. This is fucking crazy. I just used Justin Timberlake and Bones in the same fucking sentence, my nigga. What? How is that possible? How is that possible? Bruh, this project is something fucking insane. You listen to this shit while you're drunk? Nobody ain't come help me, they rather burn me down. Bro, this mother... Bro, holy shit. I cannot believe that this motherfucker is singing this good. Well, I got what I fucking asked for. This motherfucker is rapping. He's talking about how he be fucking all day and he can't stand up and how he told his girl not to come because the shorties are over. What type of shit is that to tell a girl not to come over because other girls are... Did the beat drop? Did the beat drop? Belly in his bitch, yeah, going super hard. Yeah, belly in his bitch, yeah, going super hard. I don't really know where I'm going anymore, but I know I got your hoe, and we going to the store, and I know I got your hoe, and we doing it some more, doing it some. Dude, I'm That sounds fucking beautiful and insane. I know we're about to get some shit, by the way. God, don't trust me. Don't get mad at me for fucking pausing. But guys, I can fucking freestyle whatever the fuck I... Not whatever the fuck I want. Okay. But nigga, the melodic shit? Oh. Call me fucking Veil World in this bitch. Call me fucking Juice 2Wise in this bitch. I'm impressing myself with these freestyles. When I edit this shit, I'm going to be like, whoa! Bro, I'm going to be losing my fucking mind. First line of the song, you said you love me, but you never around. Now I know how it feels and I have nobody fucking around. Dude, these lyrics are crazy, man. He's talking from the perspective of somebody who's a, like, not a piece of shit, but somebody who's admitting that they had a troubled past and that they weren't the best person in the past. And it takes a lot of fucking growing to do that and admit your wrongs in the past, because you don't have to go in the past. You can just move forward. You don't have to go back to the past. So when you're admitting that you did something wrong in the past, when you don't have to, it takes a lot of fucking strength. And I don't think a lot of people understand that until they become a fucking adult. I promise you, it's only a few more things stronger than that person who's admitting that they were wrong. Because when you grow up, when you become my age, which I won't reveal until a little bit, a few people know, but when you become my fucking age, you realize that a lot of people are not like that at all. At all. No matter where you go, no matter what circumstances you're under, no matter if you're under poverty, if you're in a rich neighborhood, 70% of motherfuckers are pieces of shit. I just don't give a fuck what nobody says. So, as long as you admit that you have fucked up in the past, in my book, you're far from a fucking piece of shit. Far from it. Far from it. And that goes for if you grew up in a racist home and your parents may be fucking racist and you grew up with that and grew out of that and you admitted that you were wrong as a younger man or a kid even. That takes a lot, man. That takes a lot, and people don't fucking understand. But let's dive into this before I get on some fucking Martin Luther King fucking Black History Month shit in this bitch. I have to pause it again. I know how it feels to be lost and found. I just think, dude, this is so fucking beautiful. But if Bones just added another layer with his deeper voice. Oh my God, if he just added another layer to this higher pitch with the deeper pitch in the back. I wouldn't be able to listen to this. I'd have to turn it off. I'd be like, guys, I don't know how to break this to you guys, but. Fancy. Woo. Please stop. She's meowing and then, yeah. Guys, we're all used to it now. We're all used to it by now. Fuck it. God. I love how all these songs are short. We're just fucking diving in them. This piano, this rapid. I don't got no phone, bruh. Please, bitch, don't ask me. I don't want your phone number. Bitch, I'm busy ashing. Bro, this nigga Bones is on some shit because, nigga, I don't have a phone. I have a phone. I found my old iPhone that I don't. Nigga, I don't have a phone. I don't have a line. I could, but I don't want to. I don't want to, my nigga. I have to deal with all of you guys messaging me on IG and Twitter and wherever the fuck else you can find me. I don't want a phone. If I had a phone, so many people would be texting me that don't fucking text me, like, old numbers I forgot or deleted or something. Like, this is why niggas don't have phones, bro. Literally, because people are so fake. I can't wait for nobody. Time is for no one. He said, I do this shit so easily, man. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Nigga, that's how easily he's doing this shit. The fucking alphabet in this bitch. It's honestly fucking insane to witness because I have not heard another project. This is my first project from him, and everything else I've heard is OG shit. I've only heard one recent song from him. This shit is driving me crazy. Please, white pimp, bitch. I don't really know. I'm going off the head, bitch. I didn't even know that the beat was really going. Oh my God, bitch, I'm going off the dome, bitch. Oh my God, bitch, I'm going off the dome, bitch. Do it so easily. Bitches be wanting to suck on my peaky. I don't fucking know, guys. I don't fucking know. I didn't even know the beat was going to end. I was in the middle of talking. God damn. Was I in the middle of talking? I don't fucking... I didn't expect the shit to fucking end. But, damn, that was beautiful. It feels like that was probably the most 50-50 song we've gotten with the rap and the singing at the same time. That's probably the most 50-50 song we've gotten. This shit is outstanding so far. We only have about 5 more songs left. All these songs are very short and sweet. Our next song is Deja Vu. Cannot play current song. Bitch, why? Saying cannot play current song, but it's playing. I don't need your love. I just need my fucking space. Nobody will understand that unless you have depression. It's pretty hard to describe, honestly. No matter how far we get into this thing, the surprise factor that I have from hearing Melodic Bones just grows every fucking time. The one-liners in this goddamn album, holy hell. Okay, our next song is The Waiting Game. I'm ready for this. We're on our last 4 songs. Let's dive. Man, this second half is super relatable, man. He's talking about if she goes, he'll be waiting for nothing and he'll never be the same. That type of shit, like how he's never met somebody like this that made him feel anything. Like, you know, like that's super relatable. Super, super. Oh my God, that humming. Oh my God. Oh my goodness. He's killing this shit. I love in this song, Bones has all the confidence in the world, but he's admitting to loving this goddamn girl and admitting that a lot of his emotions are behind his love for this girl. It's actually pretty fucking phenomenal to hear because it's a mix of emotions, not just one solid emotion to label the song, you know? I'm fucking with this. Feeling lost in the sauce, bitch. I got all this motherfucking sauce, bitch. Chicken nugget sauce, bitch. Alright, that was fucking beautiful, fucking, melodically. Like I said, it was a bunch of mixed emotions. That bass fucking drop, whatever you want to call it, surprised the hell out of me. I thought it was going to be a majority of guitar, even though it was, but that bass kick kept on hitting you. I loved it. I fucking loved it nonetheless, though. Our next song is Don't Tell Mom the Babysitter's Dead, featuring Eddie Baker. What the fuck is going on? Imagine having to tell your mom the babysitter's dead. This beat has a bunch of different bass drops and fucking kicks and damn, holy shit. The guy who fucking produced this shit, they said, yeah, drums and bass. Anything else? Jesus Christ, this shit's fucking fire. I'm pretty sure Bones produced this, by the way. I'm loving this shit. And I love when Bones switches up his flow with the voices. That shit's phenomenal to me. Big ass blunt, light it up while we swerving. Dirty ass mouth, wash my words down with bourbon. Bitch, I don't rap, every verse is a sermon. My shit is some niggas that be burning down churches. This is my shit for niggas that be burning down churches. Still not lacking. Left him all bloody, then I threw his ass a napkin. Mess with my room. Fully focused, bitch. I'm around town. Getting knowledge from my older chick. All about my dick, cause it's longer than a room. I didn't go to college. This is some ignorant shit I would listen to in high school. Oh my God, this is some shit I listened to in high school. Start bitch, roll a blunt, then I go to rock. Every song hit like a bomb drop, then I rock. I don't follow rules, bitch, I do what I fucking want. I run the globe and it won't never ever stop. I thought it was gonna drop again. This shit, that beat was phenomenal. Our next song is Hey Stranger. I love those fucking flows and verses from those two artists from the last one. But this guitar strum is kicking my ass, guys. I did not want to pause it. Holy shit. Dude, these songs are hitting home, man. He said, it's been a year since I've heard your voice. It's crystal clear that you've made your goddamn choice. And he's wondering if she even thinks about him. That shit's deep. My thoughts are so. My way out. You took me for granted. You Oh. I was the only one you trust. I was the only one you love. I was the only one you fuck. Now you giving all the attention I want. Bro. Guys, what the fuck is happening, man? Show this shit to Tracy. Shit. Tracy. Come get me, man. Let's record, bruh. This shit is phenomenal, man. We're only two songs left. It's really one long song because this song is a minute. It's an interlude again. And the last song's 2 minutes. So let's dive into these last two songs, man. Our feature and Vellies are crazy today. But this project is in its own lane of fucking crazy. It's fucking crazy Steve crazy. How fucking beautiful this thing is, man. And I love how it's put together. Everything is not in one category, fucking segregated across the whole album. It's scattered. And I love that. I fucking love that. My dear friend. Y'all heard that? That song seems like a song of concern. He's concerned about his friend. That's what it seems like in that song. I love that interlude. I love it. But again, I feel like if Bones just added one more layer with a deeper voice, it would bring that higher pitch together so much well. But I love the higher pitch. I don't get me fucking wrong. I love it. But I feel like if he added just one more layer of the lower pitch, oh, just imagine how fucking phenomenal this high pitch would sound with his lower pitch, man. Okay, this has been a crazy project. Our last song is Gone with the Wind. We finna be gone with the wind after this, cause this shit was crazy, bro. Holy shit. I'm just fucking playing. With those first two lines, we have to assume the Gone in the Wind reference is for the girl he's been talking about this entire time. We hear what you, Bones. We all understand heartbreak, and it's never easy, no matter how old you are. Heartbreak is never something that you will just step over. So if you're somebody going through heartbreak, don't beat yourself up because you're so down about it. Because no matter how much your friends pretend like they don't give a shit, I promise you these motherfuckers are crying for girls. I promise you, nigga. I promise. I have girl best friends, bro. They tell me everything, my nigga. They tell me everything. I don't wanna wait. I just keep it moving, nah nah. Oh. Gone with the wind. Gone with the wind. Now I'm moving. Gone with the wind, and I'm choosing to leave you in the past, bitch, you snoozing on me. I done had all the bullshit.
Hey, I don't wanna do that, but a new day. I don't wanna show that side. Wanna take a look back, you ain't gonna shoot back. Woo! Rolling through your town, fly, fly, all I was doing was up, and you ain't trying to puff up.
I don't know who to trust. I don't know who to love. I don't know who to love. Gone with the wind. Gone with the wind. I just got a twin and she's sucking on my dick. Oh my God. That's the album. And I want more. Not taking anything away from the album. This thing was put together fucking crisp. This thing was fucking crazy. Oh, don't get me fucking wrong. Just because I want more doesn't mean that this thing did not fucking deliver. It delivered a lot more than I anticipated, and I anticipated a lot. Like, God damn, man. You have to give it up for Bones, bruh. You really do. This guy's been doing this shit for almost 10 years. He's probably been doing it for 10 years. And he's brought all his friends along. And he's never forgotten the core goal. And it's getting all your friends up with you and having fun doing this shit. And not selling out. That's why you have to give this guy his fucking respect. He never sells out. And that's why he's known as one of the OG underground kings of this generation. And that's why I fucking love me some goddamn fun to fucking Bones. But, man. Motherfuckers walking around and shit is getting on my fucking nerves. But, that has been the album reaction. It has been fucking phenomenal. I cannot believe the amount of fucking melodicness. I don't know if that's a word, but I cannot believe how much Bones was singing on this thing. I am absolutely fucking impressed. I need more. We need to watch him live now. Everything, man. I love Bones. I gotta get a poster, something, man. We gonna have posters of everybody in this bitch soon. But if you guys enjoyed this album reaction, please, 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 make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. It really helps the channel grow. Get out to more Bones fans. Get me the 10K subs. Get this hair gray. You know, it's a cycle. We all have to work together, but. And you hear motherfuckers walking and shit? This is why I'd be taking forever to fucking record. It has been your boy, Velly. Fucking Two Wise. See you guys next time. Jesus Christ, I'm irritated. Holy shit. Look at my face. Look at this smile. It's so unnatural. Holy shit!